Finally, we got rid of all of the fancy colors on 483, and she returned to normal. As a matter of fact, the director wanted the Rio Grande back on the tender also. So all of my hard work to stencil the cumbersome toll deck on 483's tender was for naught.
Judging from the gaps on those rafters, it looks like one good snowstorm and that thing would have been history.
That was about it.
Yeah.
This is the governor's train, October 4th, 1970. Both governors, I believe, were invited, but neither one could make it. So this is actually the first excursion, a VIP excursion from Antonito to Cumbersome on the Cumbersome toll deck. And the railroad was just a little over a month old. Just west of Bighorn, some guys, some bandits on horseback came running down to the train and held us up. All of the people on the train had to detrain. And luckily it wasn't real, it was just a plot to raise some money for the preservation of the railroad, and I guess the bandits got away with $15. There you see them, that's the Black Hills gang or something, who knows. There they all are from Antonito.
Wow.
Near Sublette, the aspens are really pretty in the fall. As a matter of fact, there's even some orange ones right there in the center. Almost every fall you see those orange aspens near Sublette. They're rather unusual. Proceeding west from Sublette. I'm sorry, we're at Sublette now taking water. We were almost. I'm getting ahead of myself, sorry. Phantom Curve. It's a photo run, I believe, at Phantom Curve. There's Virgil Bockhouse standing on the ground with his green cap. And to the right of him is his son, Alan. And on the platform on the caboose is Ken Pruitt. And on top of the caboose, leaning against the cupola, is none other than Alan Stevenson.
You guys like riding on the roofs a lot, didn't you, back in those days?
Well, we wanted to play it safe.
The rock tunnel at Toltec Gorge. A photo run, yep. That's a flagpole there on the front of the engine. Reboarding the train. Hey, on the top of the caboose are now are Terry and Alan Stevens, as a matter of fact, with a white hard hat. Now we got Alan Stevens' son on the ground looking up in his black conductor's uniform and a peelbock hat. Arrival at Osier. I believe the citizens of Osier had put on a mutton dinner for us, for everybody on the train, so it was quite a celebration. And I believe even some of the outlaws were invited there on the right side of the picture. They probably spent the $15 that they took away from us for lunch there at Osier. Hey, there's Dick Glass between the rails right in front of the engine. And we're getting ready for the group photo like that.
All right.
Everybody by now has probably seen the plaque at the current plaque at the Chama Depot. It was the same situation as this. Only here we have it in color with a Kodachrome slide. Unfortunately, whoever took the picture cut off Ken Pruitt there on the right side. You can see half of him. And we're proceeding on further west to Cascade Trestle, where we had a photo run. Good shot. 137 feet high. That's a pretty impressive trestle.
It's a twin in a way to Lobato, isn't it, as far as construction?
Yes. Yeah, very similar. Probably built at the same time. Uh-huh. Okay, guys, it's time for a break.
Terry, you wanted to give voice now?
Sure.
All right, well, some of you guys are taking care of business. The rest of you get your cards out. I'm going to turn on some lights, hopefully.